planet Earth, home to over 7 billion people, a place where people's livelihood depends on its rich resources. Earth provides its inhabitants with the essentials they need to lead happy and healthy lives. Ideally, it will continue to yield its bounty to sustain us and future generations. Unfortunately, we also live in a world full of pollution. We are plagued with pollution of our air and our water. Ocean pollution is something that not only affects marine life, but humans as well. 60 years ago, ocean pollution was barely a problem and seldom mentioned in scientific circles. But today, a staggering amount of waste enters the oceans each year, causing biochemical, behavioral, and reproductive imbalances in every one of Earth's species. Along with industrial and agricultural contamination, litter and garbage from humans play a big role in the deterioration of our most precious natural resources. Humans and animals need to have clean water to survive. Humans can only survive 3 days without water. We have the right to use and drink unpolluted water. We have no right to pollute what we have. Additionally, when discussing water pollution, one cannot overlook the effect it has on our coral reefs. It is undeniably a major concern. Even more urgently, at least to us in the Pacific Northwest, with such huge agricultural and fishing industries, polluted water can easily have devastating effects on Washington State. It's time that we become aware of the devastation that is taking place in our oceans and make a plan both locally and globally to save one of our most important natural resources, our water. All around the world's warm coastal ocean areas, these coral reefs exist. Interconnected cities created entirely by Mother Nature. Coral reefs help to filter pollutants and provide a home for the animals inhabiting the area. Not only is this delicate, intricate system supporting the dozens of species living in the reef, but also provide extensive benefits for the humans on land as well. Reef systems support the fishing and tourism industry, which yield jobs and increase stimulation of the economy. Unfortunately, the air of coral reefs, being this beneficial, is quickly deteriorating. Due to increased population, the demand of the fishing industry and housing requirements have been more relied upon than ever before, both adding to the various pollutants added to our ocean waters. With the escalating pollutants, global warming brings a domino effect of issues to the ocean. Increased temperatures from the heat and cocktail of chemicals contribute to both coral bleaching and increased ocean acidification, respectively. This global warming is caused mostly by the burning of fossil fuels like coal and oil, which gives off gases like carbon dioxide, methane, and nitrogen dioxide.
CO2 emissions are an important issue and how they relate to our global warming temperature. You can look at CO2 levels in ice from like the Arctic. So you can see how it has changed over time, and you can correlate that with big changes in, or big events in human history.
But how does that relate to coral reefs? The answer is coral bleaching.
From single-celled algae that live inside the coral polyps, it's where they get their greenish-brown color too. They're called zooxanthellae, and like other plants, they get their energy from sunlight. That's why coral reefs mostly grow near the surface of the ocean, where the sun shines. But this partnership breaks down under heat stress. After multiple weeks of temperatures, even just a couple of degrees Celsius hotter than the maximum temperatures that they're used to, the photosynthetic system in the algae starts to accumulate reactive oxygen molecules like hydrogen peroxide, which leak into the coral polyp cells. To protect themselves from damage, the coral polyps kick the algae out of their bodies, leaving the pale skeleton showing through.
But if these conditions continue, entire reefs are at risk. These reef ecosystems most frequently hold up the food chain, providing resources to the smallest organisms in the area, like plankton, phytoplankton, and polyps, essentially the backbone of what makes up a coral reef. Polyps are what give life to the coral. With pollutants like carbon dioxide, methane, nitrogen dioxide, mercury, and hundreds of others, our ocean acidity is increasing along with the temperature, throwing off the delicate pH balance for many species. Overall, if we continue the trend that we have going currently, our ecosystems are bound to go under. And this issue isn't one that's happening deep down in the middle of nowhere either. This is an issue that's happening here, and in our own Pacific Northwest backyard. Washington State has its fair share of water contamination. Just like the coral reefs, our fishing and agricultural industries are slowly deteriorating. Most concerning is the rise of heavy metal poisoning. Lead-based paints is considered a hazardous material and has been proven to cause cancer in humans. Just because lead contamination is not commonly talked about does not mean that it's not an issue of concern. Every year, millions of gallons of raw sewage has entered our beautiful Puget Sound as a result of faulty pipelines and sewer treatment plants. The nearby city of Edmonds experienced 8 million gallons of raw sewage spilling onto its streets, wetlands, and finally into Puget Sound.
Environmental issues in Washington, probably the biggest one would be water quality, because so much of our economy depends on the water and our recreation depends on the water. So anything that's affecting the water, so it could be the ocean acidification from climate change, it could be anything from sewage treatment plants that aren't working right, that are putting sewage in the water, all of the non-point pollution that's coming from our streets and our yards that are going in the water.
If the name Flint, Michigan sounds familiar and you saw the pictures of the thick, cloudy, brown water being consumed by its citizens, you have seen the future of Washington. If we don't pay diligent attention to being responsible caretakers of our beautiful and bountiful ways. However, a common argument against the hard facts of ocean pollution is that it doesn't directly affect us, and that there are more important issues to focus on, like war, homelessness, or what have you. While we would 100% agree that there are more important and direct issues that our world leaders are working with currently, environmental issues are still extremely prevalent. In 2016, Hurricane Matthew brought destruction and poverty to Haiti, along with over 200 new cases of a disease, cholera. Since then, over 770,000 people have been treated for the disease. Created by the bacterium Vibrio cholerae, cholera is transferred through, you guessed it, contaminated water, from feces, sewage, and fish. Not only does cholera have significant health effects on humans, but it can also disrupt the ecosystem, causing a large decline in shellfish populations. Additionally, another chemical is found in similar conditions, mercury. Although mercury use has been under better controls in recent years, it still makes its way through the ecosystem through contaminated fish. Effects of mercury include severe nervous system damage, birth defects, and lung problems. If we simply controlled our waste incineration and recycled mercury-containing products, many of the pain and suffering of those with mercury poisoning could have been prevented. Earth's water is under assault. Our planet, in its infancy, was covered with a global ocean. Over the years since the beginning of humans, we have unwittingly, and for the most part unknowingly, created a crisis. Today, we are faced with the consequences of our ignorance. Our beautiful coral reefs, which purify our ocean waters and provide life support for the flurry of aquatic life, is being saturated with pollutants. Our state, with its robust fishing and agricultural industries, is slowly dying. Our local cities and their citizens are being poisoned by metal, lead, and human waste leaching into our drinking water. Yes, there are those who will say that we have more pressing issues to deal with, but if you think about it, if we don't deal with the pollution of our water, will any of the other nightmares our world is facing really matter? What we have presented to you today may seem like a gloom and doom scenario, but there are steps we can take to save ourselves from the brink of disaster we find ourselves facing. Be more diligent in the disposal of your garbage, both in our landfills and our oceans. Support legislation to protect our drinking water and aquatic life. Join the 193 nations who believe that global warming is real and have a profound effect on how we will live in the future.